Well, hello everyone, and welcome to the last video for 2023 on the workshop. This is a year-end video. We're going to be having New Year's Eve tomorrow. I figured, why not get out the newest kits that have been released since we did a new kit video? It doesn't mean that these aren't on the market already. Most of these you see right here have not on the market yet, I can guarantee that. But we're going to see some stuff we've already built up. I'm just going to do a wrap-up of the year of things that have come out since we did the last new kit video. First up will be all the awesome stuff from REVELL, specifically REVELL USA, but also REVELL Germany. It's got some stuff on the table. First in front of you is the video we just did. If you missed it, go and watch the full build of this 2022 Corvette C8 Z51. This is a brand new kit from REVELL USA, designed from the ground up, not reusing parts from the other 2020 Corvette kit from REVELL, which is more of a press fit type. This is an all new, full option kit, full engine build. It is gorgeous. We've got a left hand and a right hand interior in this car, and the vehicle itself is exquisite. I've glued it all together. It fits beautifully. It just works the way it should. That will be coming out in 2024, because there's no way this test shot is going to go to final production in the next couple of days. So let's put that on the side. Boxed up kits that we'll see built on the show beginning in 2024 from REVELL is first up the 1/24th scale Aston Martin DB5. They've got the 007 license, so does Round 2, but REVELL also snagged the 007 license. One of their first issues will be the Aston Martin DB5. This one's in 1/24th scale. It is their Easy Click system. You could call it Snap Tight, whatever you want. The new name for it is Easy Click. It is a beautiful model, 122 parts. Should be a pretty cool machine. It's got the James Bond accessories on it, like the little wheel spikes and all that stuff. So that should be a fun kit. That should be a very easy build. I think it's even molded in partial color. They give a shot of the sprues, so I wonder if it's not molded in silver there, being part of the Easy Click system. So we'll take a look at that, see what's going on, get that built up. Then I just built Round 2's version, so we'll get to take a look at the difference between the two. What is the difference between REVELL's 1964 Impala SS Lowrider in 1/25th scale and the difference between that and the Round 2 version that I've built on the show already as a dragster? This has some newly tooled wheels in it. We can check out the beautiful buildup on there. If you're curious, where do we got the data sheet on the REVELL boxes? 154 parts. That's a lot of parts, and it is the Lowrider option on there. When I build it up, we're going to see if it's got some other stuff in there, if you could build it as a stock Impala or not, but we'll wait till I build it to get into all those nuts and bolts. Another one up in the 007 line is their gorgeous 71 Mach 1 Mustang. It is a sweet ride. It is a beautiful kit that goes together lovely. This is in 1/25th scale from Diamonds Are Forever. I've actually done this car from AMT. We got a REVELL version. Now, just because it has the movie on the box top doesn't mean that you, the builder, have to build it as the 007 car. You could do it as a yellow Mustang, black, green, purple, hot pink, whatever you want, build it up. Do it as a weathered ride. You're going to have 121 parts to work with in that box, and that will be coming out in 2024. So if you're a big James Bond fan, you can snag it. The classic 57 Chevy Bel Air. This is a kit I'm positive I built up in younger years, unless this is a reissue of a more modern kit. I'm not sure, but almost everybody's built a 57 Bel Air back in the day. 1/25th scale, skill level 5, 186 parts on this little beauty. Check out the options on the box: bone stock, street rod, custom interior, stock interior. Looks pretty sweet. So being a 57 Bel Air, we got to get a video done of this little beauty on the channel. We're not even close to done. The shipment they sent with that Corvette was big. One of the biggest shipments REVELL's ever sent. The sweet 1977, that's me vintage. I'm 1977 vintage. Jeep CJ7 Golden Eagle. Love that root beer paint job with the tan interior and the warm gold wheels. We got two build-up options on the side. We got a hard top. We got a soft top on there, a lot of cool stuff in this kit. You will have 136 parts to work with. This one's definitely getting a build. I know someone that loves Jeeps a lot, so I may have to do it in a color scheme for them and give it to them, but we'll take a look at that one, what's in the box. Also, a version of the Ford Bronco. We saw this as a three-in-one kit. I built up the Ford Bronco half cab in 1/25th scale, their newly tooled kit from a few years ago, as the half cab when I did the dune buggy and trailer, but a lot of people didn't want to buy all that extra stuff. So they released it as just the Bronco half cab. And this is a beautiful box art with that red and white top. You're going to have 140 parts to work with in this thing. And then you can get this. I love the off-road tread white walls. Those are pretty sweet. That box art is just gorgeous. Chris over there does a great job on the box art. Finally, for cars from REVELL USA, 1968 Pontiac Firebird 400. This is in 1/25th scale, so we know it's usually a REVELL kit. The 1/24ths were usually monograms. This is a sweet looking ride. For once, I love that their box art builder, Bob, didn't use a conventional color. We got black street rod here, but now we've got this green metallic with the green interior. That's definitely something that I would have done on the show, and I still may copy his work on that, because I love that. I love when they go non-conventional. Everybody and their brother does red, orange, black, you know, all that stuff. You go it really stands out when you go different. This one does have 122 parts in the box. This one's definitely getting a buildup because everyone loves the Firebirds. Then we've got a nice airplane. You can pick this up. It is the German Messerschmitt Bf 109 G10 from World War II. It is in 1/48th scale. They call it quarter scale in the modeling world for model airplanes. This little beauty has 40 parts. Shouldn't be that difficult of a build at all. So you'll be able to see this at all your hobby retailers. Hobby Lobby will carry this for sure, and you can go snag it. And finally, as a special gift to me, they sent over this kit. Is not available in the US market through normal channels. You won't be able to go to your standard REVELL USA dealer and pick this up. But hobby shops, online warehouses, specialty dealers will be able to find this and get it in for you. This is a REVELL Germany release of a Star Wars The Mandalorian kit. This is the N1 Starfighter as seen in the show. I know when these vehicles came out on the show, the old AMT Star N1s were selling out left and right. People were modifying them. But REVELL jumped on that with the Star Wars license, tooled up this brand new 1/24th scale, 77 part model of the actual Starfighter from the show, weathered and beat up and stuff like that. So if you're looking to pick up this little beauty, let's find the product number on it somewhere. There you go. Google that, 06787. Beautiful kit, 77 parts, 1/24th scale, and you can build up your own Naboo N1 Starfighter from The Mandalorian, or do anything else you want to do with it. Paint it up as a World War II fighter. Do whatever you want, because this is pretty sweet. And if you've seen what they've got coming out with the Star Wars license, I got to get all of this stuff from REVELL Germany. They're going to be having a speeder bike come out. It's not the old MPC reissue. It's an all-new tooling of the speeder bike. It's a big one. I think it's like 1/16th scale, maybe, if not bigger. Maybe 1/8th scale. I'm not really sure. Haven't seen much on it yet, but I know it's coming. So we'll try to get that on the show. Maybe build some trees behind it. Do an indoor diorama if I can. Otherwise, it'll be built up from The Mandalorian with those speeder bikes with little Grogu and a pouch and everything. So I am going to set up for the next bunch of items, and I will be back in a moment. Next up is ModelRoundup.com, who has been a longtime sponsor of the channel, loves to send over the latest kits, the stuff that you don't get a hold of through all the main channels like AMT and REVELL. They've always got the cool stuff on the side. They will import kits that a lot of dealers will carry. They will do a lot of stuff. First thing they do is they carry Model Cars magazine, and they've got the latest issue, issue 222. They've also got back issues in their online store at ModelRoundup.com. Snag your issue of Model Cars magazine with your next order. It's got a lot of cool stuff in there. You can always check it out if you're into just car modeling, vehicle truck modeling. Model Cars magazine is the one you want to get. It's the only one on the market for that stuff. We've done a full build of Tom Daniel's Sidewinder since the last new kit video. This is a 1/24th scale kit. I did a lot of custom painting on this beauty. You can go on the channel and check it out. They got sweet box art on this issue. I forget, how many parts did this thing have? 46 parts, not a lot of parts, but it really built up into a sweet kit. So pop over to the channel homepage, check out that 1/24th scale Tom Daniel ride there. Also built up on the channel is Aoshima's 720 Datsun truck. They say they always word them differently when they word them from Japan and all. 720 Datsun is what it is, or Nissan pickup truck in the United States. I did it as a World War II bomber. I thought it would be so cool to do it up like that. This is in 1/24th scale. It is a curbside kit. It is a lowrider only option. You cannot build it as a stock Datsun in this version. They sell a ton of these Aoshima kits for Toyota, Nissan, Datsun. They've got a lot of stuff on their website at ModelRoundup.com, so check it out. This one I did as a World War II bomber with some custom slicks decals from ModelRoundup.com as well, so make sure you stop on their site and grab that little guy when you're looking up this monster. This big, beautiful Mack Bulldog. This is the old monogram kit. Atlantis Toy and Hobby purchased a lot of those molds. I've talked about it in other reviews. So if you weren't familiar, I'll tell you again. They purchased a massive amount of the old monogram REVELL tooling, the old stuff that they REVELL didn't have any plans to re-release ever. And they are reissuing it. Model Roundup sent over this Mack Bulldog 1/24th scale. I built it up just as it is on the box art with a little more custom painting and some weathering on the chassis and the wheels as the Ringling Brothers Barnum & Bailey truck. I loved this build. I've built the log truck. Those are the two they've released so far. As far as I know, there is a dump truck that may or may not ever see the light of day. I don't know where the molds are for that one, if Atlantis has them. And then there is a tanker truck. And I'm pretty sure they have the tanker truck molds, and that will probably be the next one we see if they reissue them. So go to ModelRoundup.com, snag this up, Mack Bulldog Steak Truck, get the logging truck, see my videos on both of these beauties. Again, we'll look this one up, 130 pieces. It builds into a really large truck, almost 11 inches long, and it is an absolutely gorgeous build. In fact, you know what? It's actually sitting down here. So wait while I wander off camera, because it is sitting down here. If you don't think that kit is cool from the box art, and you haven't seen my video, there it is. That is a gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous little model kit. So we'll set that on the side. We'll probably get to hear that crash in just a moment, and then I'll get to build it again. So snag this. This is available right now, just like the rest of the stuff that I'm showing you here. Also, I built up in a 2-for-1 video. I'm not a scale snob, so I don't go, it's not my scale. And that's fine if you prefer only one scale, but you are missing out on a ton of kits. 1/32nd scale from REVELL. We've got a tanker. We've got a reefer. It does include these decals in it, so you can get those actual ice logos in the kit with the striping. Thermo King reefer to freeze down the trailer. We've got this kit here, the American Premium Tanker. It also has decals for Canadian Premium. These are press fit kits and they come out very nicely detailed. If you picked up any of the Macs, any of the GMCs, the Chevy Bisons that I've built in this 32nd scale, you're gonna want these trailers to go with it, and they're a lot of fun to build and they're a lot of fun to work on. On this beauty here, on the tanker truck, only 46 parts. I built two of these trailers in 2 days, and I did a full paint and detail on both of them, and I was able to get them done that fast. So you could build the truck and its trailer in a weekend without a problem. The reefer's got 48 parts, a few more parts inside that one. Videos are on the channel. Things that aren't on the channel yet. they sent over from modelroundup.com. Yes, they can even get Airfix model kits. The Bond Bug. This is a really interesting vintage classic from Airfix that they're reissuing. It's in 1/32nd scale. They had built these three-wheeler cars to get around the smaller streets of Europe in the United States. Somebody's yee-yee big pickup truck would drive right over the nose of that and squish them. But in Europe, the roads are narrower. They drive a little slower on those narrow roads. The houses are close together, the hedgerows and all that stuff. They developed these vehicles. They didn't really take off, but it is a cool-looking machine, and they sent it over. They were able to get it from Airfix. Isn't that cool? It's got the little driver figure and everything in it. A lot of it is clear. And then you'll paint around it to leave the parts clear. We've got like the roof panel to go over it. So even in 32nd scale, it's not too small to build. It's gonna look pretty cool. That should be an easy knockout or a weekend build. If you're looking to add something really quirky to the model shelf, you gotta grab yourself that little Bond Bug from Airfix. Now we've got Salvinos JR model kits coming over. You saw me build up that Earnhardt kit recently. And where's the box for that one? Let me go wander back in the shop. I'm having fun doing this to you guys, this one. Just because someone had said my videos need to be way more professional. And I'm like, why? We're just having fun out here building models. So since the last build, I built up Dale Earnhardt's number 3 Richard Childress Racing GM Goodwrench Monte Carlo Aeroback. All right, Aero Coupe. That was a beautiful, fun kit build. Well, now, Salvinos JR Models through modelroundup.com is now issuing the Fords, the classic 1/24th scale Ford Thunderbirds. And the first one, of course, first one, the 212.809 mile per hour 87 Ford Thunderbird that Bill Elliott drove, the Coors Melling oil pump race car. This thing is sweet. We're definitely doing a build on this because it's the first, just like I've built Aero Coupes before, but I had to build the Earnhardt one, bringing the name back, and we definitely got to build up the first Thunderbird. My dad had built some of these. He wasn't a huge Ford race car guy, but yeah, finally, Salvinos JR, finally. It's taken a lot of years of doing only General Motors and Mopar products to get the Fords out, and I know a lot of you guys are going to be really happy about that. So get this one through modelroundup.com. Get it on pre-order. This one's just coming out. One that is available right now is Richard Petty's 85 Pontiac Grand Prix. This is in 1/24th scale as well. Old monogram reissue. Beautiful car, comes with the decals and everything as you see on the box. They build up so easy. You've seen me build a lot of these on the channel. And the Pontiacs were real hot looking. The Buicks were my favorite. The Regals of these stock cars like this in this G-body style were always my favorite. But the Grand Prix is definitely a close second. Then the Monte Carlos, unless it's got Earnhardt's name on it, then it's number one in my books. So we've done all we can for modelroundup.com. Here is a little addition. These guys are just someone who got a hold of me. This is their company, J Diction. Let me show you the name so you can Google it easier. J Diction. J Diction. They have a water-based resin molding system. So you don't need UV lights, you don't need an oven, you don't need all this stuff. All you need to do is mix it up per the instructions. They've even got a silicone mold making kit that dries in a translucent clear. They've sent over their kit. They've also sent some pre-made silicone molds so we can try it out really quick and see how it works. All different kinds of stuff that we can mold in different shapes, pumpkins, stuff like that, whatever you want. So we're gonna give this a shot in a short video, see how it works, see if I can figure out how to make a mold so that if you need to replicate model car parts or model airplane parts or anything, you can use something this simple. You don't have to learn 3D printing, which I don't care what anyone says. The learning curve on that stuff is quite steep for now. It'll eventually come back to normal, you know, be really easy to use. But for now, this kind of stuff makes it super easy, water-based, so you don't have all this horrendous fumes in the house and all that stuff from UV resin printing and all that thing. You can print, you can copy some model parts right at home. Spare engine blocks, valve covers. Wheels are a very common thing to mold. So we're going to be taking a look at the new JD Diction ResinCrete. We're going to be taking a look at their silicone mold making kit and casting some molds, see if I can do it, see how the detail turns out. I am going to reset for the next products on the line, and I will see you in just a moment. And now up next, this channel sponsor goes by two letters, M-E, it's me. I've picked up these cool model kits, toys, dioramas, anything I like to show you guys what is new since the last new kits video. We've got some collectibles on here. We got RC stuff coming. I mean, that's a lot of cool stuff. So first up by X Plus Models, we've got Revenge of the Creature plastic model kit. It's in 1/8 scale. This thing is so cool looking, but they don't have a picture of the built model. Well, this is one of the built models on there. Builds into a very large diorama. You can see by the size of the box. This one you can pick up. It's by XMODEL. You're just gonna have to Google it. They're not a channel sponsor or anything. You'll have to check out where to get that. Also by them, Jurassic Park. How cool is this? T-Rex chasing Jeff Goldblum with the fence behind it and the wall all included in the box. Got this gorgeous Jurassic Park label. It's in 1/35 scale, which means in this diorama, you can see Jeff Goldblum is about three and a quarter inches tall in there. So you can imagine the size of the T-Rex, the wire wall, and everything behind him. That's going to be a pretty sweet build. That's going to take me quite a while, so that's maybe what I call my retirement kits and all that. But these are available, and get them quick, because when they sell out, they are gone for a long time. It's a newer model company. They're pumping out new models left and right, so they don't have time to go and reissue and restock. All my little collectible figurines that I love for the hobby room to show you guys. We got Svengoolie. If you're familiar with late night crappy television, local TV movies, this guy here, he'll show you the worst horror movies that have ever been made that are so bad they make you laugh, but they're good as well. So he's on MeTV all the time doing his syndicated horror show. He's been around since before I was a kid. And then the Mistress of the Dark, Elvira. This is a Toonie Terror, so they're more caricatures. But you remember that Mobius kit that I reviewed years ago? Well, this would be the same version in a Toonie Terrors kit. We got the couch. We got Elvira splayed out on it. We got Gonk the dog that she's got all punked out. You can get that figure right now. Also in model figures, I've been collecting these General Mills cereal box figures. We got Booberry with the ghost and the little box inside. The little magnet closing door looks like a cereal box. They do it as if it is the calories on the side, so it looks every bit like that. And you can collect all the different guys, Frankenberry, all of that stuff will be available in that line. If you're looking for any of this stuff, just go ahead and Google it up. I know in a review a while ago, I showed you that I was collecting the Dungeons & Dragons cartoon characters, and finally they came out with the rest. I had the dragon, I had the bad guy, I had the little dwarf, and now we've got Presto, Eric, and Sheila. So we complete the cartoon characters from the awesome 80s cartoon Dungeons & Dragons, based off, of course, the role-playing game. These are available now. You can get them at places like Walmart. You can get them online, wherever you want. They are made by Hasbro, so they will be available nationwide. Anyone can get a hold of them. Not a problem to snag those up. Finally, 40th anniversary of that show and all that stuff. Then, I gave a hint on this on the Facebook page. Playmobil came out with a Magnum PI car. They've been doing Marty's truck and Ghostbusters and all the cool stuff. Finally, the epitome of 80s cool, the Lady Killer, Thomas H. Magnum, Magnum PI. Got him right there in the Playmobil character. Got his Ferrari 308 GTS Quattro Valvo. It's a sweet car. I'd love to get a hold of one of these when I win the lottery. Even has his Detroit Tigers hat on there. And you'll get Magnum, TC, Rick, and Higgins. And Higgins is holding a bird. I don't think the only thing missing they should have done were the two Dobermans, Zeus and Apollo. That's my only improvement on this one. Maybe they'll reissue it and get the two dogs on there. That would be absolutely primo. So you can snag this. Again, the people that are my age, 40s, this was their jam. So these things sell out fast, like really fast. We've also got some die-cast coming up that I've picked up. I found this one at a Fleet Farm, of all places, in their toy section, the Jaws Blazer, and I would have never found it in that if my friend Katie hadn't taken a picture of it and said, look what Fleet Farm has. So I want to shout out to my buddy Katie. She's a nice lady. She always likes to show me all the cool toys that she sees. I got this at Walmart. Auto World store, you know, we get kits from them all the time. That's Auto World is the retail outlet of Round 2 Models. Yes, the Plymouth Voyager minivan, the first edition. My uncle had a tan on tan one or gold on gold, so I had to get this one. Got the chrome roof rack, got those ridiculous white wall tires, got the old man tan interior. You can snag these up. They're in true 1/64th scale. And then the other day we were up at Blaine's Farm and Fleet and Hot Wheels motorcycles. I've been grabbing all the little Hondas I can. This one is their CB750 Cafe Racer. So that's pretty cool. I wish they'd make one of my Trail 125 and of my 1100T that I just got for Hot Wheels. Maybe they will. That'd be pretty awesome. More of the personal stash, if you like figurines. I mean, how can you not like Willie Nelson? And a figurine? Is that, and it's a fabric coated one. Those are the rarest ones to get. It's got his guitar with the hole worn through it. Got his hat, his braids, all his different bandana. And see on the back, includes trigger guitar with strap, bandana, cowboy hat, and guitar playing hands. So you can switch out the hands when you want to hold them. It's got his red, white, and blue strap on the guitar. That is, there was no chance. I had this on pre-order for like 6 months and it finally came in. Willie Nelson figurine. Gotta have it. You gotta go and buy that immediately. So Google that. Also, RIP, rest in peace, my main man, Pee-wee Herman. So sad that he passed away in 2023. I had these on pre-order. I didn't even know if they were going to issue them because he passed away before I had them, but they did, and that's why I'm leaving them in their little plastic baggies that they came in. We've got a sweet Pee-wee Herman plushie with the rosy cheeks. If you can find these online for their standard price of less than 10 bucks, get them, because with him being passed away now, you're not going to find these things. They're going to be really hard to find. And from his Playhouse cherry plushie. So that's so cool. These are just memories that I have as a kid, and I know a lot of you are my age group, and you're excited to see this stuff, and you're gonna go snag it. So if you don't like it, that's cool. You always fast forward through the section anyways. From Target online, the cheapest place I was able to find it. Atari, actual Atari, not just thing. Released by My Arcade, more than 200 original Atari games from the 2600, 5200, 7800, and Atari Arcade. All those systems in one that you used to have to buy for hundreds and hundreds of dollars back in the day. Wireless Atari controllers with triggers and the standard buttons. Hooks up to your HDMI output over 200 games, including Pong, Centipede, Asteroids, Breakout, Gravatar, all the great stuff from the day. Target had this available. If you use your Target card, you get 5% off, so it kind of takes care of the sales tax. And I had to get this. I don't know if they're out of stock on these already, but if you can find these available, grab them, because they're going to become hard to get. All the Atari stuff goes out. And now, instead of plugging in my original 2600 and worrying about wearing out the switches and the controller, I can play all my games, all 200 plus. I don't have to own all of them anymore. And I never owned a 5200 or a 7800 or the computer system. I just had the 2600, so now I get to play all those cool games. We're not even done, though, on personal stash, because it's been a while. I picked up the all-new Tamiya BBX. It's a 1/10 scale buggy. This is all new, but they made it look retro. They went back, literally back to their roots, and designed this from the ground up the way we used to race RC buggies back in the day. My very first RC buggy was a Kyosho Raider Pro. It was a kit. It wasn't one of the almost ready-to-run ones. Built it in my basement, enjoyed it, put a Futaba speed control in it and a Futaba pistol grip radio, and just absolute blast. And that's what this reminds me of. The old school RC buggies with the large lug tires, the rib front tires, the cage, the driver inside. It looks like a real buggy. They're now issuing these. I hope to see a racing class for these. I hope someone locally gets one in, and I would love to take this down. Oil shocks, all that stuff. You can put a brushless motor in it, all that stuff. So this is pretty sweet. These are also getting hard to find. Some of this RC stuff out this year, they're getting in limited shipments, and they are hard to find. Now, for something even harder to find than my BBX, something really hard to find right now, I have to reset the camera because it is absolutely gigantic. So I'm going to get that on the table, get it ready to go, and I'll be back in just a moment. All right, peeps, do you see the size of this thing? It is absolutely gigantic. It is a 1/4 scale radio control motorcycle. It's the Pro Model by LOSI. They developed this. It's all new. It's not a reproduction or a reissue of one of the older, more crappy RC motocross bikes. You can get it ready to run with a battery, a radio, and everything. You can get it with just the radio, requiring the battery and the charger. However you want, you can get it in Honda colors. You can get it in Yamaha colors. Whatever you want, if you can find this available right now with any kind of coupon codes, snag it up. I got them immediately when they were issued. I heard about it, saw it advertised, got my pre-order in, had to wait, and then finally it arrived. This is massive. 1/4 scale, 1/4 scale of the real thing. The box is big, all right? But let's just, We're just gonna do it right now. Look at that monster. We'll get the camera in there closer so you can actually get a good view of it. Look at that thing. It is gigantic. Massive. I have fifth scale gas RC cars and they're big, but when you look at this with the rider on it, it is ginormous. Here is a 1/25th scale model car that I build on the show all the time. This thing takes up a huge chunk of my workshop, and it's full of amazing parts. They give you this center stand so you can display it in the house. People will just walk in and go, holy crap. They've got a start stand like they do at the races, and that's because it has an internal gyro that has to spool up to an extremely high speed with a brushless motor to hold the bike stable. It's got a kick plate with a spring, because even on real motorcycles, the back kick plate, it always breaks. It breaks all the time. The plastics are flexible. All the handles are flexible. We've got cords and wires. We got a flexible driver that sits on top. We've got real rubber tires. This thing even has, get her off the stand here, and it's heavy. I think it's like 8 pounds. It's got working front and rear shocks, actual shocks that work, like the real thing, with guards on the forks. Check this out, just like my fifth scale gas RC cars, real disc brake, a floating disc brake with a caliper actuated from the radio. Isn't that cool? And it is a floating disc brake, see? It moves, just like the real ones. To stop the bike, that is nuts. A real chain drive, not a hidden gear drive, that's all fake. Look at the Dunlops on this thing. And you can get a set of Motard tires as well, tires and wheels that go on this for street running, so you don't have to ruin the Dunlops if you want to run this around parking lots and all that and screw around. It comes with these sidebars. I suppose, take them off, but if he crashes, you're going to do a lot of damage to the bike, and when it's running around, you really can't see him anyways. But, I mean, you always could take these off, you know, if you didn't want the training wheels, but I don't recommend it, but hey, it's your model. Real fabric jersey that can be removed and washed and reinstalled. He's got goggles on. Isn't that just the coolest thing? I knew you guys had to see this. If you weren't aware of this model already, I definitely wanted to get it out here and show you, because you gotta have one. We got a real metal swing arm. We've got our huge oil-filled shock in the back, the big mono shock. I mean, almost every single thing the real motocross bikes have, this one has. Now, whether you ever want to drive this or not, these are instant collector items. Some hobby shops are only getting one or two of these things in. So I really say you definitely got to pick these up if you think they're cool, because, you know, they're going to be hard to find. People are already making upgrade parts for them. I just think it's so cool to see that real metal chain in there. They show you how to tension the chain. They give you spare parts to tension the chain, and you can pick up all the spare parts and a set of Motard tires with it and everything. You can get better brake pads. People are making all kinds of stuff, so I wanted to show you that. So that's the personal stash stuff. Let's get back to plastic model kits, and I will be right back. Well, unless you've been living under a rock, you know that I've been building a ton of kits since the last New Kids video. So we got a lot of stuff here that we built on the show, didn't show in the last New Kids video. Some of the stuff has already been out. Some of the stuff is still coming out because it does take quite a while for the rest of the kits to hit the open market. We've got round two models out in front of us. You can Google on their website. You can Google. Google is just a generic name for searching nowadays. You can search on the autoworldstore.com website for all these kits as you see them, and then see which ones are available, which ones you can pick up, or just check with your favorite hobby retailer, you know, like modelroundup.com. First up, I did a full build of the 1/25th scale Fruoff 40-foot exterior post van. Did this up in the Dorn. I weathered it. I showed you guys how to detail it, how to use cheap pastels, artist pastels, chalks, craft paints to weather this beauty up. Check on the channel. Fruoff 40-foot exterior post van. This kit, I think, is available right now. Same as the semi-trailer Fruoff tanker. Now, I think that this 9,000-gallon tanker has been built on the channel as a Sunoco tanker, but I could be wrong. This one might be the circular one, and I've done the oval chrome one. So check the channel. Let me know in the comments. I'm going to check it too as well. I just completely had a total brain fart when I started this video whether I had built this kit. It will hook up to any of the 1/25th scale AMT tractor trailer kits and even hook up to the 1/25th scale Revells and Mobius kits out there. So this one does have the circular one instead of the oval, and it's in the Gulf livery with those gorgeous decals on there. Look at all the parts in there. Now, remember the trick from building the Sunoco tanker is when these are chrome, if you know, if it is chrome and you want to paint it chrome, to get that fingerprints and the shine back, you can always spray future floor polish on it. You can brush it on it, or you can use quick shine floor polish. Brings back that chrome luster immediately. Next up, another build I did on the channel. Opening hood and doors is the 55 Chevy Bel Air hardtop. I did a nice custom job on this one with purplish and metallic paints. It's got a massive decal sheet in it. It's in 1/16th scale. It is a huge kit, but it's still not too, it's about shoebox size is what I like to call the 16th scale. Bigger than your 18th scale diecast. You can turbocharge the engine, which I did on mine, and I will show you in that build video if you want to check out that for the 16th scale 55 Bel Air, where they have you cut out the fender, built the custom turbo with the custom air intake, and made it a really sweet ride with their custom wheels and tires. In that kit, you get two entire sets of wheels and tires built up. The 64 Ford modified stocker, another modified stocker kit out on the market. I've built a ton of these because I enjoy building it. It's got those massive pad printed Goodyear tires on the side. You can see the parts box. They're two pieces. They're just gigantic, and they are realistic. They are. I've shown pictures on the Facebook channel, which you should follow for seeing stuff like that, of the modified stockers running those massive slicks outside the wheel wells. This one has the 427 wedge engine and builds up super easily and super, super duper fun. A car I had a lot of fun with is the 69 Plymouth Barracuda in 1/25th scale. I built it up as pretty much a custom ride. I did a blacked out hood with a scoop. I put the side scoops on it. We did it in a lime green. I modified the decal stripes to accentuate that. I put a spoiler on it, used all the parts in the box. It's got seat belts, custom parts. You can do whatever you want with this kit. Builds up super sweet. You can see all the stuff back there. Includes one entire set of tires and a set of drag tires on there. And I really, really enjoyed that 69. I thought it was pretty, pretty sweet. A brand new kit for 2023, all new tooling. They did not, this is not the 32nd scale. So many of you in the build video of this kit and in the unboxing that I did, which are both on the channel, made the incorrect claim, I had that kit since I was a kid. That's the same thing. No, it's not. Completely different kit than the 1/32nd scale. It's got all the features. Fully loaded, rolling arsenal. It is a monster kit. It is pretty awesome, so I want you to check that out on the channel and get out there and get your own copy before they sell out. And those new kits tend to sell out of their first couple runs immediately. A perennial kit that is fun to build. I'm pretty sure I built the Dodge 330 from AMT before, 1/25th scale, built it again, loved it another time. you can either put in the 383 or the slant 6 in your builds. Either way, you get two complete engines on there. We've got steelies. We can build a drag version. We can build a race version. Tons of parts in there. Only one set of tires, though, so watch yourself when you build it up. It builds into a gorgeous kit, and I have done that Dodge 330 on the channel as well. We're not even... Look at all this stuff. The Mach 1. Here's one I have not built yet. New in a shipment, still plastic wrap. This is due out at any time, celebrating 75 years of AMT, the Mach 1, W-O-N, get it? Play on words. This is a funny car. It's got this really smooth body. I like how on the front, they just have it being very, very generic, like the guy just painted the fiberglass and hit the track. It's got the big honking full Moco 427 with a blower on it. It includes Shelby mags, American mags, vinyl drag strips. It's got the individual chassis rails. It has a huge decal sheet. Siemens Fords on there, Mach 1. Got that big funny car body. This should be quite an interesting build when we get to building that one up. What else we got here? Well, this is the second time I built this kit on the channel because I loved it so much. It's AMT's 1/20th scale 1992 Toyota. It's got some of the lifeguard parts from the Baywatch edition still in it, so I built it up as a lifeguard's truck in yellow with the red buoys on there. This is the old Lindbergh kit, so if you've built that kit, you know how nicely they go together. They are really awesome. Great off-road tires. The interior is spot on, and the engine looks just like the 6s available in the 90s. It builds into a gorgeous kit. It's got all the proper decals to backdate it and all that. So every time that comes out, let's hope they reissue the Nissan hardbody and the Sonoma. Then I've done a full buildup of their 1966 Oldsmobile 442 W30. I did it up as a box art build, but with a white roof and a white interior. You got to see that build. Comes with red stripe tires from AMT. It is an easy to build kit with a lot of detail. Some people, I mean, you could be your first model kit. You can knock these out in a weekend. I do almost every car kit you see on the channel. I bust them out in just one weekend. Then, we were just talking about this when I showed the REVELL kit. This is AMT's Super Street Rod, the 1964 Impala 1/25th scale. I built it as a side box art. I built it up as the Bad News 427 powered dragster. Now, when you open up the box, you'll see in the review, it's not really a 427 under the hood. You'll see what it is in the kit when you watch my review. But it's got a huge set of tires, all right, in there. Beautiful detail parts. And like I said, I did it up as the box art on the side here. Show you how to mask in that review for the black stripe and the black top and all that. Painted it gold. Loved it. Check that video out. From the 80s? Yes. These are becoming classics because they're 40 years old now, or almost 40 years old. 86 Dodge Shelby Charger turbo car. All right. Front wheel drive. They brought back the Charger name in these coupes. At least these ones have two doors, unlike the modern ones, which are four doors, which Chargers never were. You've got a couple building options based on wheels and decals. You'll decide. You've got a set of louvers in there, set of gorgeous hood and stripe decals. We've got decals to do all the way along the bottom. I masked mine and painted it, but you'll see how you can get those all on there. Easy to build, more modern kit. You've got fender flares. You can leave them on, put them off, anything you want to do. Kit's got quite a few color options in the decals. One of the most recent videos that's really doing well on the channel, and why not, is John Wick's, you know, Keanu Reeves, 1970 Chevy Chevelle SS. Now, I've built this as Wooderson's Melba Toast. This kit was also released as Jack Reacher's Chevelle. And one of the comments, or more than one person said this in the comments, and I had to laugh hysterically. They said, well, that looks just like the John Reacher and the regular 70 Chevelle SS. Well, of course it does. It's a 70 Chevelle SS. They're not going to have different bodies on them. It's going to be the same car, just with different stripes or a different color or a different color interior. On the John Wick one, they let you replicate it. They issued the matching wheels to the movie and a gorgeous set of pad printed tires in a brand name that I haven't seen before in an AMT kit. So go ahead, build that up. You've got white and black stripe options, so you do not have to build it up as the John Wick 396 powered car. You can build it up any way you want, but either way, get that kit because it builds up nice and the grill pushes into the nose easier than it used to. a brand new kit that I don't know. I mean, this video is coming out on New Year's day before New Year's Eve. So December 30th, I don't know if these have hit the market, but they are close. They are getting close. They should be on the big boat. They should maybe shipping to dealers pretty soon. The all new 1971 Dodge Demon 340 by MPC 125th scale. I just oozed happiness all over this build. It builds up beautifully. It's modern molding, so all the parts go together the way they should. No issues, no fighting, no fuss, no muss. They've got a gorgeous box art. We've got all the decals you can see in here. Striping's done for you. Tail lights, side stripes. We've got big Demon logos if you want to do the dragster. All of that. It's got the spoiler on there. It's got the 344 barrel under the hood. Everything. It's even got a set of drag slicks and stock tires. Loved this kit, and I'm hoping there will be other versions. Maybe we'll get lucky and they'll be able to do a duster. We can do Al Bundy's car. Then we've got the U.S. Postal Series Edition Steel Box 1970 446 pack Challenger. I just had that on the screen in this video. That's how nicely that kit builds up. That is it on the screen for you. I did the full build of this one with that gorgeous hood decal, side stripes. I did a vinyl top on it in the video. We got the nice bumpers on there rolled in. We've got a set of rally wheels on there, which are easy to make look authentic. Black letter tires. And then we've got that sweet 446 pack sitting underneath the hood. So that's how this one builds up. Check out that video. Comes in the collectible Postal Service tin box. Looks just like a model box, but like a little lunch box. Put a handle on it, make everyone at work jealous when you pop out your PB&J. Being reissued. I did this kit years ago on the channel, so I'm not going to build it again. Though, personally, I may glue it together in an hour and enjoy it. They're reissuing Jolly Roger's Hex Marks the Spot, where the guy is on the wheel. This is the my favorite one of the Jolly Roger series. This would be the Pirates of the Caribbean reissued without having to pay the license fees. They did it up in a glow-in-the-dark. So you could assemble it. It glows in the dark. Otherwise, you can go back on my channel way back and see my build video. It's an older video, so it's not up to snuff of the modern ones where I show a lot of the assembly and stuff. But great kit. Get it. It's being reissued. And just because it's glow-in-the-dark doesn't mean you can't paint it as well. All new as well. They've got to be next to ICM. ICM is also extremely productive. But next to them, Round 2 Models has to be the absolute most prolific U.S. model maker on the market today. Nobody else has as much stuff, new stuff, and reissues coming out as them. We've got this sweet-looking 1/200th scale Artemis 1. This is one of the first times the United States has developed an all-new rocket, a new NASA rocket, to put people into space. And they built a kit on it. In fact, Chad and Jamie from Round 2 got to see this in person. They just had pictures on their Facebook page where they got to go check this out. So it's a beautiful all-new kit, full decals, 19 inches tall, comes with a beautiful display base, 38 parts. I mean, it's a rocket, so you're not going to need a lot of parts. It's going to be more painting and decaling than anything. All right, they're going back to the moon. We're going to land people on the moon again. Artemis is where it's going to start. So if you love air and space or just American history, you know, when the space race was going on, every kid was building Apollo space rockets and Saturn V and all that. Now you can get back into it. A modern rocket, get the kids back into it. They can watch these fly on YouTube, on NASA's YouTube channel, and then they can build it themselves. And that's how you inspire lifelong modelers, by letting them see something that they can see in the modern day. Because most kids aren't interested in 70 Challengers. They've never seen one in person. They're so rare now. And finally, from AMT, these are in the box. These have both been reissued before. They've got new livery on them. I haven't built either one, so I'm going to have to decide which one of the two. Tell me in the comments, which one of these two do you want to see built up more on the channel? Because the big trucks take a lot out of me. I really rush through them because I got to get them done for the videos. So there's a lot of stuff to do on these, all right? We've got the Ford Louisville line short hauler. It is a straight truck with the more modern Ford front end on it, the more, you know, conventional style front end on it, with the Morton Salt decals on there. It's got the girl, got the Morton Salt, the doors, Love that paint scheme. It is a huge kit, well over 200 parts, 286 parts it says on the box. Big, big kit. It's got that Caterpillar fuel-injected V8 diesel engine. So this is a complex build. It's even got a lift gate on the back and everything. Trail mobile body. And we've got the Dodge L700 truck with flatbed racing trailer. Now, I've built Ford semis, I've built Chevys, I've built GMCs, I've built Volvos on the channel. I don't think I've done a Ford or a Dodge heavy truck before. So I'm kind of leaning toward this. Plus, it's got the trailer, it's got the cool decals, it's got a tilt cab, it's got loading ramps. I don't know if it says how many parts are in this one. If it does, I'm just missing it. But we've got a huge part set for the trailer, a huge part set for the truck itself. We've got a big, beautiful decal sheet to replicate the colors on here. So we just have to do a little bit of masking on that. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do a three-tone on this, but we'll see if I end up building this one up. So let's check these out. Let me know in the comments which ones you want to see the most. That is all the kits since the last new kits video that I've gotten in to the shop. I want to wish you all a happy new year. I want to thank everyone who sends kits in for the show. I want to thank all of you who watch all these shows. Over 100 kit builds a year on this channel for another year. Plus random side videos. I want to do some other videos on the side of my new motorcycle and stuff like that. As soon as I'm doing a longer term test on the big motorcycle, because everybody reviews a motorcycle like Cycle World and Revzilla. They drive it for 35 miles and then tell you it's the coolest motorcycle they've ever owned. I want to put at least four figures on that new bike, take it into the dealer, have them do the oil change, deal with all that stuff, and then bring it back and take a look at it for real. A real review on it. Just like on the model kits, I like to at least open them up, do an unboxing, and then most of them I do a build on so we can actually see how they actually work. So we're going to be doing stuff like that. We got some tools on the show. I bought a four-wheeler, a Polaris 450 utility, brand new one. So I want to do some parts on that. I want to show you guys some stuff that I see people asking online about those things, and nobody ever answers them. So I want to be able to answer questions on those now, and some products like muffler silencers and rack bags and all that kind of fun stuff. So take it ice fishing, review some of that stuff. So look forward to some cool stuff in 2024. We're going to have a gajillion. We're going to do at least 100 more kits this year, two every week. We're not stopping that. And I thank you all. So happy new year, everyone. Be safe. If you're going out, drink reasonably, have someone give you a ride home, and I will see all of you at the next review.